A tool that can be extremely valuable and have a few uses, but is often overlooked, is the markers feature. Now for me, markers are an absolute must if you want to finish every single track that you start, and we'll look at why that is. Plus, in addition to just marking a spot in your project, in Mixcraft 10, they can also have creative uses as well. So let's have a look at how to add markers and how you might want to implement them into your workflow. And we'll start with how to add them. There's a few ways that you can actually add the markers. So we'll start with the first way with our first marker, which is going to be right here. And that's to go up to this section in your project, this timeline part up here, and just double click where you want to add the marker. That easy. And now we have our new marker window here, and we'll give it a name. This is intro/verse 1. And there is our first marker. Now we need to add a marker right here for our next part of our song. And for this, I'll show you the second way that you can add a marker, and that's by holding down Control plus the forward slash on your computer keyboard. I just did that, and you can see the same new marker window pops up. So I'm going to call this pre-chorus. And now we can look at the third way to add a marker, and we'll put one right here. So what you want to do is click wherever it is you want to add the marker, and then you go up to mix, and then in here you go to markers, add marker, and again the new marker window comes up. So there's a few ways you can do it. Whatever one works best for your style and your workflow, you can use that. Try them all out if you like, and for this section I'm going to name it chorus. All right, so we have three markers here. One of the things to note is the way we did marker 2, and that was by holding the control and forward slash. A good thing about that is if you're recording somebody else and there's a section that you kind of want to go back to or something you want to mark, you can do that on the fly. You can hold down the control and the forward slash while it's recording, and it's going to put a marker in that section. So now let's have a look at the new marker window and what's happening in there. So I'll click there because I want to add another marker there. And this one I'm going to call after chorus. It's just a little section after the chorus. So title is self-explanatory. Offset, that shows you where exactly the marker is. And you can change that in here if you want. Color is something that I like to use all the time. And typically for sections like this, I like to color it a purple color like that. And you can see here, you can create track for CDs or audio files, and you can use the ISRC numbers in there. If that's something you want to do, you can click that and do that. Now, down here is the section where you can get creative with your markers. So you can do tempo changes with your markers. If I wanted to change, you can see my tempo right now is 145. If I wanted to change it to something else, I would click here, change the tempo, and then that way everything moving forward is going to be that new tempo. Same with the key. Right now it's in the key of C, and if you have your project set to follow the key, you can do a key change, add a marker. You can change the time signature if you want, and you can even change how the metronome behaves at a marker as well. So you can see there's some creative uses in here, but there's also some valuable uses with your title and the color. And this is going to help when you start recording. So if I was to start recording my bass guitar to this, or guitar or vocals or whatever else, it's nice to have these markers up here so I know where I am in the song. Now I've added these other three markers here, and you'll see that there's a start marker that's always there as soon as you open a project. I'm not going to worry about that one, but if I want to change these ones that I already created, maybe I want to change the color or any other settings in there, I can go up to view, and then I can go down to show marker list. And over the side here, we have all of our markers. And now say I'm in the mixing portion of my song and I want to hear everything from this after chorus on, I can just press this play button. And you can see it starts playback from that section right there. Same with if I wanted pre-chorus. It starts playback from right there. If I want to change the color, I can do that here. And that is what I want to do right now. I'm just going to quickly change the color, because when you're recording, it is nice to have these different colors up here. And when you're going back to mixing, if you use similar colors every time, it makes things a little more familiar for you. And also from the marker list here, I can add more markers. So I'll want to click where I want to add that marker, and I'll say right here, click the plus marker button right here in the markers list. And we have that new marker window. This one's going to be verse 2. And I'm going to change the color right away to that blue of the other verse. So I've gone ahead and created all the markers for this song. You can see they're all up there. Now, when I start recording the next part, which will be my bass guitar, I'm going to know exactly where I am in my song because of these markers. And if I were working on a song where I needed a tempo change, I could easily do that from the marker list over here. I could go to whatever marker and I could put a tempo change in right from the marker list. I could also change the key from over here in the marker list and our time signature over here as well. And you can delete any of your markers using the X's in here. Next up, we're going to look at clip editing and a feature in the pro version called track regions. So I'll see you in the next video.